Good evening, everybody. It's the Farm Girl K. I'm back with a new video helping you turn your farming businesses into a success. Yesterday, we talked about how to prepare a seedbed. The other day, we talked about how to grow the managu, the types of managu you can grow in Kenya, and everything that you need to know about the seeds. You can check the video in the link up here. Today, we are going to talk a topic that everybody loves. I love it too. About money and making money out of our agribusinesses. And I'm going to start this conversation with a comment that I got from one of you. He's called Alex Matasi, and he just told me actually a while ago that he's making 12,500 shillings after every 10 days in a quarter piece of land. And now he's planning to expand his piece of land to increase the amount of money he's making out of managu farming business. He says that they are selling the managus at 65 shillings per kg in their place. Farmers, if your managus are not in the seedbed right now, I mean in this rainy season, you're committing a very heinous crime. You should actually be arrested for it. Anyway, let us jump into our conversation today. We're going to talk about whether managu farming is a profitable venture and the markets that you're going to be selling your crop. Is the managu market farming profitable? Yes, it is, guys. It is very, very profitable. And I'm feeling so excited because it is not just something I am talking about. It is something people are doing. If you're not doing it, umeachwa nyuma sana, and you should actually be catching up with us. Anyway, the managu market is very profitable because managus take a very short time to grow. After 4 to 8 weeks after you have planted your managu, you're already harvesting, and you will be harvesting for the next 4 to 8 weeks. So if you follow that procedure, you'll be having 3 grow season, but you can have an all year round season if you actually strategize on your managu farming. You structure your managus in such a way that every month, every week you're harvesting. If you want me to talk about how you can be harvesting managus all year round, comment below and I will be up for it. The prices of managu vary according to location, but mostly in the Nairobi environment, we sell them from 500 shillings a sack to 2000 shillings, and this is all dependent on the season. During the rainy season, the prices go down due to oversupply, but during the dry season, they go high because of low supply. But you can still be making your money because even if there is oversupply and you're selling your managus at 10 kilograms, it means that you're having a lot more managus to sell. So if you manage to get a customer, you will still be selling at a manageable price. In the dry season, there is little supply, but the prices go high. So the managu market is always on top. Yeah, kila wakati tunaantu ni kuan. So a farmer in Maranga is making 36,000 shillings from a 40 by 100 piece of land, and that is a weekly revenue of 9,000 shillings. So in his case, during the dry season, he makes 6,000 shillings, which is also still a good money. So the difference is actually 3,000 shillings between the high season and the low season. Planting managus in large quantities is the only thing that will help you to keep earning a good profit out of your farming business, because you will be having enough to supply to your customers, whether it is in the dry season or it is in the low season. And managus demand are always high. So the managu market that you can target in Kenya are groceries, supermarkets, open air markets around Nairobi and Kiambu. Some of these include Kangemi, Muthurwa, Wakulima Market in Nairobi, Organic Farmers Market in Karen, another one in Kikuyu, Kibra, Wangigi, all of these markets, schools and hospitals, which are more unstructured. So this one you'll have to go and sign a contract with them. But it is actually a better way because you will be knowing that every day, every month, every year, I have a supply of customers, and you will be selling at an agreeable price with the institution that you select. And you can also target restaurants and hotels. Apart from growing the managu, there is also the benefit that we get from eating this crop. And some of them are, it has got a lot of proteins. It also has got a lot of iron, calcium for bones, vitamin C that helps in growing your skin, glowing your skin, If you do not want to age quickly, my friend, consider taking some managus frequently. It is also got some vitamin A and B and fiber that helps in constipation. So, kama unaendanga mahali alafu unasikia, consider taking managus. So, thank you guys for watching. Those are the tips that I wanted to share with you today. And as you have seen, a farmer is currently making 12,500 shillings from the venture. It is a profitable one. You just put in the resources that are required and your time and your love for the crop and you're good to go. All year round, you're good to go. So if there's anything that you'd like me to add into the conversation about Managu, feel free to comment it below and tell me what you'd like to hear or what you'd like me to expound more on. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to subscribe, comment, share, let people know about this beautiful venture. And until next time, bye-bye.